Hello, welcome. I'm Angela Schwarzkopf, and I'm really looking forward to playing some beautiful music for you this evening. When I was programming for this concert, I found myself gravitating towards music that allowed me to experience a deep range of emotions that I've been feeling over the past several months. I wanted to play music that allowed me to process sort of the strange and unique time that we are in. The resulting program is all on the theme of calming and transcendental music to soothe the soul. So I felt it only too appropriate to begin this program with a piece entitled Contemplation. Contemplation is by the composer Mark Nerenberg. Mark's music has been performed across North America and in Europe and by notable ensembles such as the Griffin Trio and the Mercer Park Duo. His compositions encompass a wide range of styles, genres, and techniques, including instrumental, orchestral, and choral music, electronic music focusing on the interaction between computers and performers, and collaborative multimedia works. Mark is originally from Edmonton, and he currently lives in Krakow, Poland with his family. I studied with Mark while we were at the University of Toronto together, and I had the pleasure of performing a piece he'd written for flute, viola, and harp. And I spoke often to my parents about how beautiful this piece was and how much I enjoyed performing it. And so they felt it was a fitting way to congratulate me on completing my master's to commission a piece by Mark for me. And so Contemplation was born out of this commission. So here are the program notes for Contemplation. Suspended in a dreamlike sense of time, Contemplation invites the listener into an acoustic world where events seem to float by at a constantly fluctuating rate. Musical ideas appear and reappear at their own pace, sometimes slowly mutating and spinning themselves into completely new forms. The perception of time is plastic, presenting the listener with the opportunity to occasionally wander musically and to dwell on a phrase, structure, or note, sonority, or timbre before continuing on their sonic journey. Thank you. For this program, I really wanted to include a piece by the 20th century harpist composer Marcel Tournier. And this composer is particularly important to me because I wrote my doctoral dissertation on him and his life and how to perform his music. Tournier was a French composer who spent most of his life teaching at the Paris Conservatory of Music. He was a very accomplished composer and won a number of awards, but he's mostly known today for his harp compositions. His compositional style ranges from romantic to impressionistic, with influences from jazz and other cultures as well. So after a lot of consideration, I decided that I would play the second movement of his Sonatine for harp, and this movement is marked as being calm and expressive. And Tournier is a master at really utilizing the resonant sonorities of the harp to its perfection. So I hope you enjoy this. Thank you. So my husband, Etienne, and I have a practice in our home of listening to what we call repeat songs. A repeat song, to us, is something that evokes a memory or a feeling and requires multiple listenings, hence being a repeat song. At the start of our time in isolation, we came across one such song. We had been listening to a wide variety of classical pieces, and one night Etienne decided to put on some selections by ERIK SATIE. And the Gnossienne number one came on, and it was such a moving performance that we just kept repeating it and repeating it and repeating it and repeating it. I felt that as I was listening to this music, I was really allowed to be emotional and sit with my feelings and to feel sad and to feel reflective and to feel hopeful. And so, of course, I had to learn how to play it on the harp. I'm gonna pair this next piece with a piece by another French composer, YANN TIERSEN, and his piece, Comptine du autre ti l'après-midi, which is most well known for being on the soundtrack to the movie Emily. And one of my students actually requested to learn that right at the start of our time in isolation, so I arranged it for her, and I thought it was just such a beautiful piece that I felt like it made a nice companion to the satie. So I hope you enjoy these two pieces.
Thank you.
So from the music of the French, I will be now heading over to Britten. And the next piece I'm going to perform is the Interlude from the Ceremony of Carols by Benjamin Britten. This choral work is normally performed during the holiday season. And the Interlude, it's an exceptional moment that takes place halfway through the choral piece. And it comes right after the movement called This Little Babe. And This Little Babe is essentially a long crescendo of layered voices, and it ends in a height of like energy and excitement. And then from this sort of powerful moment with the choir comes this quiet chant from the harp. And this is one of my favorite things to perform, because in this very moment in a live performance, I can actually hear the audience just becoming very still and very quiet and just really being very engaged and thoughtful with the harp part. And it's just this really, really beautiful moment in the piece. So I'm going to share this for you now. Thank you. We're now moving to the Canadian music portion of my program. The first piece of tonight, along with the remainder of my program, will all be pieces that are from my recently released and Juno-winning album, Detach. And the first piece I'm going to start with now is the title track. And this piece is by Monica Pierce. Monica Pierce grew up in Prince Edward Island, lived in Toronto until 2018, and now lives in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Her toy piano works have been premiered and toured internationally. She's currently working on a recording project for Textile Fantasies and multi-work set of keyboard and percussion pieces based on textiles and patterns. Sounds amazing. She is the 2020 winner of the Canadian Music Centre's Harry Friedman's Award for her solo harpsichord piece, Trois de Joie. So I first connected with Monica back in 2014 when I collaborated with the toy piano composers, and she wrote me a piece of music called Attach. And Attach was always meant to have a companion piece. So we were very lucky that in 2016 we received a grant from the American Harp Society, and we were able to have Detach be a piece. This piece feels so appropriate to include because it moves through exploring unique sounds on the harp to some very melodic material that's sometimes fragmented, sometimes confusing, and sometimes stunningly beautiful. And I find that there's just a wide range of emotions in this piece that can change from one bar to the next. And before I read the program notes, I'm just gonna briefly retune the lowest string on my harp. So this is what Monica writes about Detach. Detach is about blowing a kiss goodbye to a set of plans, skipping a rock over still water, and trying to find a light switch in an unfamiliar room.
Thank you.
The next composer I'm going to perform is Patrick ARTEAGA. Patrick composes chamber music exploring organic and fantastical themes of the natural world through naive impressions of places, beings, and relationships. He regularly plays with Kolhapur in Toronto and She York in Switzerland. His project with She York brought Patrick to a valley in Tschamiu, where Tschamiu is, and it is this location that this next piece is based on. I met Patrick through a collaboration with the Caution Tape Sound Collective, and that's where I premiered the piece, A Portrait of Tschamiu. Today, I will be performing the final movement of his work, entitled Know Nothing. And it is a calm and reflective piece in writing. The musical score features very few bar lines, no dynamics, and no phrase markings. And so truly, each time I perform it, I feel like it allows me to express in any given moment how I'm feeling. And so no performance is the same. This is what Patrick writes about his piece. Tschamiu is an area on a mountain of Switzerland. At 1,550 meters above sea level, the pastures, hay fields, and forests in Tschamiu host both the wild and the domestic. Roughly 13 kilometers from the River Rhine, forest green is woven with viridescent hay flowers alongside carrying attendants like the shoreline of the sea. The horizon is close, across the valley where a mountain reflects, drawing crazy patterns on its face.
Thank you.
The last piece I'm going to perform for you this evening is by Kevin Lau. Kevin was the affiliate composer of the Toronto Symphony Orchestra from 2012 to 2015. He has worked with choreographer and dancer Guillaume Cote on a full-length ballet, Le Petit Prince, for the National Ballet of Canada, and a short ballet, Dark Angels, for the National Arts Centre Orchestra. He is currently writing a concerto for Erhu and orchestra for Andy Lin and the River Oaks Chamber Orchestra in Houston. I first met Kevin during my studies at the University of Toronto, particularly when I was collaborating with a group called the Sneak Peek Orchestra. And my parents, once again, for completing my doctoral degree, offered to commission a piece of music for me. And I asked to work with Kevin Lau. So the result of that commission was a large-scale work called Castles in the Sand. And today I'll be performing the final movement for you called Cathedrals in the Sand. When I reach this final movement of the piece, I always feel a sense of triumph and grandeur and this sort of feeling like I can do anything. And I think it's a very nice, uplifting way for us to end tonight's program. So here's what Kevin has to say about his piece. Castles in the Sand was inspired in part by the abundance of truly breathtaking sandcastle images available online, as well as the rich layers of meaning that underlie such a seemingly simple and childlike activity. To build a sandcastle is to make something from nothing, and what's more, to make it beautiful for the sake of beauty alone. Part of this beauty lies in a short-lived, ephemeral nature of the outcome. Like a piece of music, we must transcend common notions of utility in order to appreciate it for what it is. The final movement, Cathedrals in the Sand, reprises earlier material, but cast in a different light. It is a meditation on the possibility of the sacred and its place in a world defined by impermanence. Before I begin this, I want to take a quick moment and thank the Canzona Chamber Players for having me today and for Jonathan Krem for asking me to perform. This is a fundraiser concert this evening for St. Michael's Hospital, so please, I encourage you to go and make a donation there today.